Hello friend, welcome to my channel 5 Minute Pediatrics. Few days back I have posted a picture on Facebook, the picture of a newborn with white foreleg and albinism. So this is typical case of what we call Waardenburg syndrome. So these are the usually asked in the form of spotters, and you may get encountered one or two cases in your lifetime. So I have made mnemonics for this Waardenburg syndrome, so you can easily remember the feature. Question are frequently asked in the form of a spotter. So you have identified this is a Waardenburg syndrome and what investigation you may required. So mnemonics, what I have made, Warden, Warden. Okay, here W for the child having white foreleg. Okay, the child have this, if you get this type of hair, so you should suspect Waardenburg. Okay, here A for what we have, albinism. The child is having albinism. Okay, it may have generalized. I have seen saw this case, the child is having generalized albinism. Here R for reduced hearing, so the child is having sensory neural hearing loss, so you have to screen this child. Usually the child may be normal, but you have to rule out whether the child is having hearing loss or not. Then D for dominant, those the mode of inheritance is or AD, autosomal dominant. E for eye, if we look at the eye, okay, this is the eye, the child is, and N for nasal bridge. So the inner canthi is laterally displaced, this inner canthi is laterally displaced, and this nasal bridge is broad. There is heterochromia iridides. So these are the peculiar feature of Waardenburg syndrome, and you can easily remember the content in the form of Warden and reply to the answer. So this is all about Waardenburg syndrome. So kindly like, subscribe and follow my channel. Thanks for watching.